Good evening and welcome to TV60 News Live at 5. I'm Kevin Boyce. A Little Rock man who has set to testify in a federal trial has been excused. And ice cream is coming back to Searcy. We'll have that and more as your TV60 News starts right now. Welcome back. The Craighead County Sheriff's Office says three prisoners who escaped have been caught. Jason Brown, Zachary Dunn, and Corey Kitchen escaped from the Craighead County Jail last week and had been on the run until they were captured last night. According to reports, U.S. Marshals tracked the fugitives to a trailer park near Tampa, Florida. All three men were arrested after a short chase and are currently being held in Florida. Baxter County deputies arrested a man the U.S. Army says deserted a year ago. Deputies were called to a rural mountain home residence on a report of a domestic disturbance between 31-year-old Joe Dollar and his wife. A warrants check on Dollar revealed that he was listed as an active deserter from the United States Army. Dollar was arrested and turned over to military police to face charges. A Saline County judge says he will not hear a defense motion to reduce the bond of a Traskwood woman accused of killing two people and burying them in her backyard. Reports say that bond will not be considered until 50-year-old Marissa Wright has a completed mental evaluation. Wright is charged with killing her ex-boyfriend Joe Richards Jr. in 2010 and then burying him in the backyard of the home she shared with her father. Wright is due back in court December 27th for an update on her mental evaluation and to set a trial date. A Little Rock man who was set to testify in a federal trial has been excused. Chad Davis was dismissed for the day after telling U.S. District Judge that he smoked marijuana just hours before the trial. An assistant U.S. attorney decided he believed Davis was coherent, but did not feel that it was worth the risk of having him testify. The case is set to continue through the end of the week. The company that recently bought Yarnell's ice cream says it will produce ice cream in the Searcy plant. President of the Searcy Regional Chamber of Commerce, Buck Lane, says that a Chicago-based company that bought Yarnell's ice cream will reopen the plant and produce ice cream. Lane says he has talked to Scholl and Birch Biscuit Company, and their plans are to reopen, but there is no set timetable of when that will happen. Yarnell's was forced to sell all of its assets at auction when it declared bankruptcy. Coming up after the break, unemployment is on the rise, at which Major Evangelist is starting a new reality TV series. Stay tuned.